I'm sorry about what happened that day.
I'm so ashamed of my crime.
Five killers begging for mercy after receiving extreme sentences. Throughout history, certain cases have gripped our collective fascination. Scenarios where individuals who've committed unspeakable acts confront the harsh reality of their deeds within the solemn walls of a courtroom. We're embarking on a journey to uncover these compelling instances, delving into the motives that drive their pleas, the legal system's response, and the intricate moral quandaries that unfold. But let us be clear from the start. Our purpose isn't to glorify or sensationalize these events. Instead, we aim to embark on an intellectually stimulating exploration of the intricate layers that envelop such moments. So, if you're intrigued, buckle up and join Just Scary on a chilling expedition as we examine these gripping junctures where even the most unyielding of wrongdoers find themselves pleading for clemency. Number 5. This is Valerine Cleohanno Knittle, an ordinary woman whose life took a tragic turn in May of 2009. She was charged with first-degree negligent homicide and first-degree negligent injury in Hawaii, and her actions that day sent shockwaves throughout the community. Drunk behind the wheel, her speeding truck smashed through a red light, colliding with a car carrying 17-month-old Alia Braden and her mother, Mavelin. The impact was catastrophic. Alia lost her life, and her mother suffered critical injuries. Wayne Braden, Alia's grief-stricken father, stood in court, clutching his daughter's blanket, mourning the profound loss.
Her scent is gone. Can't smell her anymore.
But what transpired during the trial is what truly defies belief. Valerine, overwhelmed by guilt and shame, tearfully addressed the court. She pleaded guilty, her remorse and devastation palpable.
I worked tirelessly to keep drunk drivers off the road.
Tears streamed down her cheeks as she begged for forgiveness, acknowledging the pain she inflicted on the Braden family. Then, an unexpected moment unfolded. Wayne Braden, in an act of incredible compassion, approached Valerine and embraced her. The courtroom, awash with tears, witnessed an extraordinary display of forgiveness and understanding. Even the judge was moved by this exceptional human moment. Valerine received a 10-year prison sentence and was required to cover medical and funeral costs. Despite the gravity of her actions, she now lives a sober life and is dedicated to preventing others from repeating her mistakes. It's a reminder that even in the darkest of circumstances, compassion and forgiveness can forge unexpected connections. Now at number 4. Meet Trey Alexander Relford, a central figure in a tragic case of murder in Lexington, Kentucky. In April 2015, Relford played a role in the brutal killing of Salahuddin Jitmund, a Pizza Hut delivery driver. Salah was stabbed to death and robbed at an apartment complex. Relford was the only one indicted, and during his hearing, he pleaded guilty to complicity in murder, complicity in robbery, and attempted evidence tampering. Facing the possibility of the death penalty, he instead took responsibility for his actions and sought forgiveness. With genuine remorse, he apologized to the victim's family.
But I do applaud you, because it takes a powerful man to know that somebody has hurt them.
In a courtroom twist that defied expectations, Salahuddin's father, Abdul Munim Jitmud, did something extraordinary. He forgave Relford and even embraced him. Drawing on his Islamic beliefs, Abdul Munim explained that forgiveness is a supreme act of charity. He redirected his anger towards the devil, the influence behind the crime.
Blame the devil. Who is misguiding you and misleading you to do such a horrible crime.
Abdul Munim's compassion touched everyone, including the judge, and he forgave Relford on behalf of his late wife and son.
Forgive you on behalf of Salahuddin and his mother.
Amidst the forgiveness, the prosecutor stressed that it didn't absolve Relford of his responsibility. Evidence indicated his significant involvement in planning the crime. Despite this, Relford's mother also expressed gratitude for the Jitmud family's forgiveness. In the end, Judge Kimberly Bunnell sentenced Relford to 31 years in prison. We are at the halfway point of the video. Don't forget to subscribe to Just Scary and hit that bell icon to never miss out on any of the future videos from us. At number 3, enter Louise Prinzo, the figure at the center of a haunting 2012 case. Facing charges for a double fatality, Prinzo's life took a tragic turn at just 24 years old. His reckless choice to get behind the wheel under the influence of painkillers, anti-anxiety medications, and marijuana led to a fateful crash on Interstate 95. The collision claimed the lives of Meredith Smith and another teenager, Lane Burnsed. During the trial, Rye emotions surged as the courtroom witnessed the void Prinzo's actions had created. Meredith's promised path, with aspirations of attending Princeton University, was cut short. Then it was Prinzo's turn. Standing before the court, he uttered a prepared statement.
Not a day goes by that I don't suffer from the guilt. It is such a horrible situation, and there's nothing I could do to fix it or make it right.
Acknowledging the guilt that haunted him every day, he accepted responsibility for the tragic consequences of his choices. Despite the immeasurable pain, the victims' families displayed a profound level of compassion and forgiveness.
We understand that people make bad decisions, and we get it. He'll forever be in our prayers, his family.
The plea wasn't for maximum punishment, but for a just sentence, entrusting the judge to make the call. Their message was clear. People make mistakes, but accountability must follow. Smith's father expressed gratitude for the community's support and recognized Prinzo's apology. The weight of the grief his family carried, however, was undeniable. In the end, the judge's verdict was rendered. Prinzo was sentenced to 16 years behind bars with an additional 19 years of probation upon release. He was also ordered to pay restitution and face a lengthy driver's license revocation. Prinzo's case serves as a stark reminder of the catastrophic consequences of driving under the influence. Number 2. Introducing Eric Winhurst, a name tied to a chilling murder case in New Hampshire. In 1985, his life took a dark turn as he found himself entangled in a crime that would remain shrouded in mystery for years. The tale unfurled when his sister, Melanie Paquette, revealed to him the unsettling truth. Her mother's ex-husband, Daniel Paquette, was molesting her. Driven by a mix of fear and concern for Melanie's safety, Winhurst made a fateful decision. Together, they confronted Daniel Paquette, armed with a gun, with the intent of confronting him about the abuse. Tragically, the encounter escalated, resulting in Winhurst fatally shooting Paquette from a distance. For nearly two decades, the case remained an enigma until Melanie confessed her role to the authorities. Facing the courtroom, Winhurst's voice was deliberate as he expressed shame and remorse for his actions.
There's nothing I can do about it, but I am. I'm so ashamed of my crime. This will never end for me.
He recounted the events of that fateful day in 1985, his words heavy with weight of regret. He apologized, acknowledging the gravity of his crime, and vowed to strive for goodness whether behind bars or not. Winhurst's attorney, Mark Sisti, acknowledged that true forgiveness from the Paquette family might remain an elusive aspiration. Ultimately, Winhurst was convicted of second-degree murder and sentenced to 15 years in prison with the potential for parole. Number 1. Samantha Davis, the 32-year-old woman facing charges for a tragic 2016 incident in Cincinnati, found herself at the center of a devastating accident. While driving her truck on I-275, she lost control, colliding with a barrier and flipping over onto another car on I-71 below. Two innocent lives were lost in this crash. Samantha admitted to being under the influence of drugs at the time, adding to the gravity of her actions. Facing charges of vehicular homicide and drug possession, Samantha tearfully addressed the court, apologizing to the victims' families. In an emotional turn, the family forgave her while still seeking justice.
I want to apologize to both your family and mine for the ripple effect this has caused. I can't pretend to know the pain or hardships you have all endured these last 3 years.
She addressed the courthouse, asking for forgiveness for the unfortunate outcome of her rational decisions. In 2019, Samantha was convicted and sentenced to 8 years in prison. However, in 2021, her convictions were overturned due to a technicality. Opting for a plea agreement, she pleaded guilty and received a sentence of 5 years and 4 months. And with that, we come to the ending of today's video. Which of these stories struck you the most with their unsettling nature? Let us know in the comment section down below. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay tuned to Just Scary for a regular dose of information and captivating content. Make sure to explore our channel for more intriguing narratives. Stay tuned as we'll be returning shortly with another thought-provoking video. Until then, take care and I bid you farewell.